Everyone, this is Amir Tsarfati. I'm live from home, from Galilee. It's about to get dark here. Let me see if I can give you the other side. There you go. See? The valley. This is the Armageddon Valley. Right there. And I want to update you about some very, very important things that took place in the last 24 hours. So first, let me greet everyone that is joining us right now. And let me see where you guys are from. Louisiana is in the house, I see. Who else is watching? Let me see in the comments. I'm on Facebook Live right now, so YouTube, forgive me, it's going to be uploaded a few minutes later. New Mexico, New Jersey is in the house. Colorado is in the house. People from Indiana. Michigan is in the house. Where else? Virginia, West Virginia is in the house. Florida is in the house. Arkansas in the house. Where else? Malaysia, wow. Hi there. Georgia, great. So folks, an update on very important things that took place in the last few hours. And if you're following me on Telegram, and I cannot stress it out more than I already did. Every other platform is censoring me. I don't know if you know, but I just told everyone on social media. I was able to, announce that I'm deplatformed from Wikipedia. Ever since October 7th, people were watching my videos and they plotted how can they shut my mouth. I mean, they cannot touch Telegram, so they went to the easiest thing, which is complaining to Wikipedia that my page there is biased, something like that. It's a baloney because there is nothing there. In fact, I was approved by Wikipedia. But they came up with some stuff, and there's many more on that camp that wants to silence me than others, and so eventually I was taken down from Wikipedia, which I don't care much because again it was just a page and we barely touched it, but that's the beginning. It's the canary in the coal mine, But never mind. Listen, what I want you to know is this. Yesterday, I'll start with what happened yesterday, and then I'll continue with what happened today. Yesterday, twice, there were UAVs that Hezbollah sent that were successfully intercepted. But what you may not know is that they were aiming at strategic and sensitive locations that are game changer if they would have been destroyed. Let's put it this way, and I wrote it yesterday on Telegram, and I'm telling you now, if Hezbollah mission yesterday would have been successful, Beirut wouldn't be standing here even today. So it was that bad. But now, fast forward to today, Israel eliminated from the air about 10 members of the Iranian Revolutionary Guard Corps in Damascus, in the most protected neighborhood, Al-Mazeh, in Damascus. It's a village within the city, which is where all the top officials live. It's extremely difficult to penetrate through all the, you know, all the security levels and filters over there. And we managed to destroy a building where the leader of the intelligence of the Iranian Revolutionary Guards, the intelligence in Syria, which means he's an Iranian general that was on Syrian soil coordinating everything on behalf of Iran. He was killed, his deputy was killed, all of the entourage was killed. So far it's 10 people, 10 bodies. And minutes later, we eliminated other people in Lebanon, north of the city of Tyre, where we killed actually the Iranian or the Hezbollah liaison between Iran and Hamas in Lebanon. So we're talking about a retaliatory action to what yesterday almost took place. A couple days ago, Hamas leader in the diaspora, his name is Khalid Mash'al, was interviewed. And he was asked about this two-state solution. And you know what he said? He said, we may have to accept a two-state solution just as a way to survive. But, and look what he said, we, Hamas, do not support a two-state solution. We believe that everything, now watch what he said, everything, and I'm now quoting him, from Ras al-Nakura to Umrashrash is ours. Now, for those of you who may not know what I just said, Ras al-Nakura in Arabic is Rosh HaNikra in Hebrew. This is the Lebanese-Israeli border on the Mediterranean, and Umrashrash is Eilat on the Red Sea, which is basically him saying, some say it's from the river to the sea, which is from the east to the west. I'm saying it's from Ras al-Nakura to Umrashrash, which is from the north to the south. The entire place is ours. They don't hide it. They say it. People don't want to listen to it. For the last 20 years, they've been saying it and nobody wanted to listen to it. And then October 7th came and they proved that what they say is what they mean. And believe it or not, Secretary of State Blinken continues to basically work on a two-state solution, on a Palestinian state solution. And he is telling the Saudis that that's what they need to demand if they want to normalize relations with Israel. And trust me, that the last thing the Saudis want is to take care of the Palestinians. Nobody wants to take care of them. Egypt built a wall that is much higher than they had before, just so no Palestinian will come in. Jordan is deploying his army along the Jordan River, so no Palestinian will cross. No Arab country is taking the Palestinians, and they don't care about them. So it's the progressive liberals in the Democratic Party in America that continue to push for a solution that no one wants, neither in Israel nor even the Hamas. So it's very interesting to see all of that. But again, what you need to understand, folks, it's very important. Israel stepped up its game with eliminating Iranian influential figures around us. I want you to know that this guy that we killed today in the suburbs of Damascus is someone who also gave America a lot of headaches. He coordinated all the attacks on the U.S. bases in Syria. And so in a way, Israel is helping America and America is helping Israel when it comes to the battlefield. But it has to be very clear, there is zero support for a Palestinian state among Israelis, and there is even zero support for that among the Palestinians. Look, if the Palestinians are so pro-Hamas, and Hamas says we do not support a two-state solution, why don't anyone listen? And he made it very clear, we don't want it from the river to the sea only. We want it from the Lebanese border to the Egyptian border. So make no mistake, the chunk of land we want is everything Israel is today. Everything, including Haifa and Tel Aviv, including Ashkelon and Ashdod, including Beersheba, everything. So why don't we listen? You know, the Israelis already began to listen to what Hamas says, because everything they practiced on and said before, they did. So when they say that they want to eliminate us as a country, it's not about Gaza, it's not about the West Bank. They want Israel to be completely wiped out. So, and it's very interesting, because I think it's the foreign minister of Great Britain in 1947 who already indicated that the problem of the Middle East is unsolvable, because one side wants to live in peace next to the other, while the other wants to live instead of the other. What they saw in 1947 is what we see even today. And remember, in 1947, we didn't have the West Bank or Gaza. We did not control the Palestinians, as some love to say. Our very existence is their problem. And we better smell the coffee and wake up and understand that it's either them or us. Because as long as right next to us, there's people who are diligently working to plot to destroy us, it's never going to work. And just so you know, I'm posting every single day more and more Israeli discoveries in Gaza. Let me put it this way. Two-thirds of the mosques in Gaza so far were actually terror houses. Two-thirds of the schools, hospitals, clinics, playgrounds. We find 100 times more weapons, infrastructures, shafts, and tunnels, 100 times more than we thought they had. Everything they did in the last 20 years, everything, hundreds of millions of dollars were poured on one thing: to destroy Israel. That's it, nothing else. And they're still being praised and supported by the majority of the Palestinians. So this is who we have around us. And it will not happen. Read your Bible. I don't see a Palestinian state there, do you? I don't. I see Israel coming back to the land that God promised. He's the one who will bring us back. He's the one who will sustain us, protect us, fight for us, deliver us from multiple problems. This war is not over. It hasn't even started yet. And it's not going to be the last war. But God is still on the throne. The Bible is still the only thing that is true and accurate and reliable, and we better stand on that ground Everything else is a lie and deception. And I'm telling you, folks, if you zoom out a little bit. I even posted on Telegram today, NATO is telling countries, prepare for World War III. Sweden just told its people, get ready. There's a war coming with Russia. Almost a war between a nuclear power such as Pakistan and Iran. We have Iraq is summoning its ambassador from Iran. We have Syria. We have Yemen. Almost all maritime traffic through the Red Sea has stopped. Egypt is bleeding. The Egyptians are charging anything from $400,000 to $700,000 per ship to cross the Suez Canal. Nothing is crossing. They're losing so much. Folks, it's already a mini world war. It's only going to get bigger and bigger as the American administration is weaker and paralyzed because of the elections. So I'm telling you, 2024 is going to be the most challenging year ever. But it's beautiful, if you really think about it. It's beautiful because we don't trust horses or chariots. We trust in the name of the Lord. And that's all we need to do. So you're going to hear a lot of stuff going on in the next few days. Israel is now training. We have exercises along the Lebanese border because we know we already gave the Lebanese an ultimatum that by the end of January, if we don't find some sort of a diplomatic solution that will push Hezbollah away from our border, we're going to have to go to a war. All the Israeli soldiers are ready. Many of them who have been released were already called in the next few months back. It's not a matter of if, it's a matter of when. The Minister of Defense of Israel just announced that he told his officers, don't plan on vacations this coming summer because a war in the north is not during the winter. It's normally during the summer. So folks, listen, first of all, this is the situation.